Hey everybody, just a quick micro review of a little bit of aftermarket I got for this rifle T-34-85 that I'm in progress building. As you see, slowly but surely, it's coming along. A lot of slow photo etch work. And for a little more photo etch work, I decided to get this ET model aftermarket kit of what's called bed spring armor. And basically, if you Google T-34-85 bed spring armor, you'll find a couple of well-known photos of these in the Battle for Berlin in 45. And these were a sort of ad hoc spaced armor where they weren't actually bed springs, they just looked like them, but they took wire meshes attached to four pieces of steel, attached them to a little frame, and then put those around the tank, making basically spaced armor. The idea was to diffuse or offer additional protection from things like Panzerfaust, the shaped warhead, single-use infantry weapons, and modern tanks use this as well with spaced armor. There's some question of how effective it was. It may have been soft enough basically to kind of diffuse the warhead and make it not trigger, which obviously would be effective. Also, the smaller Panzerfaust, just the offset distance of it bursting, a foot or two away from the armor, the jet of molten metal that the heat charges create, that was enough to make it ineffective to penetrate the armor. From post-war testing and from some British testing of similar designs, though the bigger Panzerfaust from late war apparently would still go right through these. Anyway, the Americans, the British, everyone used these add-on armors of various types during the war, be it logs or sandbags, concrete, extra tank tracks welded on all over, laid on all over. This was just a kind of interesting, visually stunning type that the Russians used late in the war. So you get a bunch with this kit. You get two sprues, and they're multiple different sizes, as you see. They're singles, doubles, and these long rectangles here. And you also get options for either a single long piece that has two legs or these shorter, little, thicker legs. And you can kind of choose either when you build it, because these were somewhat ad hoc, and every tank that had them probably had slightly different versions, or each little group that made them would make different types. Photoetch looks beautiful. It's perfectly in scale. Some of them are diagonally crossed. Some are more vertically oriented, which is cool because different panels look neat. And if you look at the actual pictures of the tanks, sometimes you'll see they were damaged, or one side was missing, probably from the crew member stepping on or bending and breaking it. And you could easily do that with the photo etch. So I think these will be a very fun kit. Obviously a niche product just for this one type of T-34, though apparently JS2 or IS2s might have worn these as well in Berlin. I haven't seen a photo of that. I'll have to go look for it. But if you're interested in making this niche vehicle from that one battle, these could look very cool.